In this video, I'm going to show you how to lock your WordPress forms. Now, the first question is, why would you want to lock your WordPress forms? Well, since you're watching this video, I assume you already have the answer. But if you're watching this video just to fulfill your curiosity, let me give you a few scenarios in which you can lock your forms and it'll be useful. If you only want your newsletter subscribers to fill out a form, you can send them the password and have a locked form on your website. You also have the ability to restrict your form to logged in users. And you can come up with any number of creative ways on how you can use logged form on your website. Let me demonstrate how we'll go about doing that. So obviously the first thing you'll need on your WordPress website to lock a form is to have a form plugin installed. And there's no better plugin than WP Forms for creating forms on your website. It's a fantastic plugin, it's free, but for the password protection ability that we're going to demonstrate in this video, you'll need to have a premium version. So what you can do is go to the website, check out the pricing, make a purchase. And once you've made the purchase, you'll see a login ability similar to what I have. Go to your account and you need to download the plugin file as a zip file because that's a premium version. So you come to this page and you go to the download section. And inside the download section, you'll find the license key and also the download WP Forms button. Click this. This will download a zip file onto your computer and you'll also have this license key. Save it to your computer and we'll be using it to install WP Forms on your website. And I'm going to demonstrate it on my website. So heading into our WordPress website, this is a complete blank install, just a demonstration website, so there's nothing on it. What I'll do is head to the plugin section here and say add new or click add new. And since I'm uploading a new plugin, I'll click upload plugin. I'll just drag and drop the WP Forms zip file that I just downloaded from the website. Install now. The plugin is installed. Let's also activate the plugin. All right, so WP Forms has been installed on our website. Let's also activate the plugin with the license key. I'll head to the WP Forms menu right here. I'll go to settings. And here in the license key section, I'll paste my license key. I already have it marked on my clipboard. You'll find it inside your account. Just paste it here and say verify key. And congratulations, the activation process is complete. So now WP Forms has been completely activated on our website. There's one more step we need to perform before we can actually create the form that we want to protect with passwords. So for that, we'll go into add-ons section here. And what add-ons are, think of them as plugins for WP Forms. You can add more ability to WP Forms using add-ons for WP Forms. And there's a specific add-on I'm looking for, which is called the Form Locker add-on. And this gives the ability to lock a form for a certain set of users. So I'll install the add-on, just one click, and it'll take a few seconds, and the plugin or the add-on will be installed. Let's wait for it to finish. So the Form Locker add-on has now been installed. Now we can start creating a new form and we'll also protect it with WP Forms password protection. So I'll go to add new inside the form section. That's all forms, add new, which means adding a new form. And this will bring up the form creation interface. WP Forms is pretty easy, very easy to use. You see all these templates pre-made for you. So you don't have to create forms from scratch if you don't want to. So for this scenario, let's take, for example, I'm sending a form to just my employees and I'm going to restrict it with a password. So I'll just use the simple contact form and customize it just a bit. So I'll just use this template by clicking use template. And I'm on the contact form creation, or I say editing section. And now I can customize any of these fields. So we have the name option here. I can change the name, first name, last name. I can have the email. For employees, emails might not make sense. So you can change to something else. I'm going to keep email for now. And in the comment or message, I'll change this to feedback. I'll go here and feedback. So let's say I'm doing this. Now you notice that it says simple contact form right now. So let's change that. So I'm changing the form name to employee feedback. Oops. Form. By the way, I went to the settings and the general settings. You can do the same thing by going manually first. I actually just click the field section and it took me directly here. Going back to the field section, now the form is called employee feedback form. We have all the things in place that we want to set up on the form, except for the password protection. So anything that you want to add as functionality onto the form, not the fields, the functionality will be found under the settings options. As I went to the settings option, you remember the general settings, I made changes to the general options, but you also have the spam security, you have notifications and confirmations. You can customize them, by the way, and we have few videos already on our channel explaining some of this stuff. So if you want to, let's say, have captures on your site, you have these options. If you want to be notified whenever somebody fills a form, you have that option. And you also have post form filling actions. So you want to redirect someone to a certain page or show some success message. That's also possible. We're interested in the Form Locker add-on. And these are all the options you'll get inside the Form Locker add-on. What you'll need to enable to have password protection is the first option, which says form verification. I'll enable this and you instantly you'll see these options. So you have a type. So in the type, we have password. We also have age and email. So let's keep it to password because that's what we're trying to do right now. And here we'll type in the password that people will have to fill in to get access to the form. So I'll type in, I love WP beginner. All right, this is the password. And this is a display message, which will just say, hey, enter your password, something like that. You can just say, enter your password. Now, apart from just using the password as a restriction method, you also have some other abilities. Let me just demonstrate them or talk about them so that you know this functionality also exists inside WP Forms. If you go to the form scheduling option, you can enable this to have the form show up only for a specific set of time. So you, let's say you have a limited time feedback section or whatever, something like that. You can enable the form section and have this. This is also pretty cool. Then you also have form restrictions only for logged in users. This is great. So if you already, or let's say you have an intranet site, you can just have logged in users the ability to fill out a form. And you also have entry limit by restrictions. So how many entries? So let's say only first 50 people, and also how many entries per user, you can also restrict that. So there's a lot of abilities except the password as well, which you can utilize to do something like that. So once you're done, once you have made sure that everything is set up completely to your liking, just click the save button and you can go back to the fields option. So everything is set up. Now all we need to do to make sure this functionality works is add this form onto our page, one of our pages on the site. And the easiest way to do this is just go to embed. I'll click the embed and you say, hey, select existing page or create a new page. Now this is a blank website. I don't have anything set up. So I'll just create a new page. I'll say feedback. I'll say, let's go. And what WP Forms will do, will create a new page for me and automatically embed the form, right? Pretty cool, right? So now it's done. Now, let's say for example, you messed up, something went wrong, or you want to add the same form to another page. Let me demonstrate how you would do that. I'll delete this form for now. Let's delete. So this brings us to, let's say, a regular page on WordPress. It can be a page, it can be a post, it can be anything else. If you want to embed this particular form or any other form created with WP Forms, all you have to do is just add the WP Forms block on the page. So I'll just type in the / WP Forms and I can see the preview here. I'll click on it and this is the placeholder. And from here, from this drop-down menu, I can select the form I want to embed. If you create multiple forms, you'll see all of them here. I just created the first form, so that's all I'll see. Employee feedback form, blah, boom. So form has been embedded. This is how you do it manually and also automatically. Now, one more thing, which is a recent feature in WP Forms is form customization or form styles. If you want to customize your form, colors, background colors, font colors, everything is actually available here. For this demonstration, I'm not going to mess with this, but you can actually go wild and change anything you like. So you have complete ability without touching CSS or anything to customize your forms. So now that we're done, I'm just going to click publish, publish. And once it's done, I'll just open the page in a new tab. And let's check it out if the form actually works. So going back to feedback, this is the form, enter your password, right? This is what we customized. I'll type in, I love WP beginner. Now, obviously you don't see it because it's a password. I'll click submit. And since the password is correct, I can now reach the form and I can fill the feedback form and submit. And once the form is filled, I'll see all these entries or I can see the notifications depending on how I've customized the form notifications to be done, right? So simple video on how to password protect your forms. If you have any questions about this or any other topic ideas you'd like us to cover in WordPress, leave that in the comments. You're watching Yuvraj from WP Beginner. I'll catch you in the next video. Take care.